pyrolysis and polymerization as a part of polymer production. As we told in previous videos regarding to associated gas, at the gas processing plant this raw material is divided into two basic components. The first is dry gas. It is the same natural gas extremely purified from petrochemical components, which are then transported through gas trunk pipelines. It goes directly to the burners of gas stoves for heating houses and electricity generation. Another gas processing product is a mixture of gases, which is called broad fraction of light hydrocarbons. In fact, gas processing is a filter that separates valuable substances to petrochemicals from conventional fuel gas. BFLH is a valuable mixture of different substances that need to be divided into separate components. To do this, the oil that petrochemical plants also purchase from gas production companies undergo physical processing. This process is called gas fractionation. Each substance has its own boiling point, so in the column it's possible to divide the mixture into individual components. The output is liquefied hydrocarbon gases or LPG, propane, butane, isobutane and others. Usually they are in a gaseous state, but for subsequent transportation they are turned into a liquid. Some of these gases, for example propane and butane, used for heating houses or as a car fuel. But most of butane and propane, like other liquefied gases, are sent to nearby petrochemical plants to produce a wide range of products. The third important stage of hydrocarbon transformation after gas processing and gas fractionation is pyrolysis, from the Greek pyros, fire, and lysis, decay. In fact, pyrolysis is a kind of high-temperature furnace for LPG. In a pyrolysis furnace, they are destroyed to create future artificial bonds between molecules. The resulting simple molecules, which do not exist in nature, are called monomers. The most important pyrolysis products are monomers. Ethylene and propylene, which are practically not found in nature, are colorless gases, the raw material for authentic materials. At the final stage, ethylene and propylene go to polymer production under the influence of special helper substances, which are called catalysts. Simple molecules combine into very long molecular chains, sometimes up to 1000 or million elements, which are called polymers. In addition to ethylene and propylene, thanks to the pyrolysis furnace and gas fractionation, other substances are obtained, vitally needed to a modern man, for example butadiene, which is also sent for polymerization for synthetic resin production. Polymers, the crown and the final of large-scale petrochemicals. The range of the processing and application is so wide that it's not transmitted even to a rough description. Subsequently, after a number of certain transformations, we receive such substances as polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride and synthetic resins, which are used to produce goods and things around us, like pipes, car parts, road materials, additives, insulation materials, tires and etc. I told about petroleum products in previous videos. You can see it passing the end screen to this video. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe if it was interesting for you.